Hello 3D printing friends, today on the BV3D channel we'll talk about the V-slot wheels on your 3D printer and I'll show you how to get them set just right so you have one less thing to worry about on your printer. Stick around and we'll get into it right after this. I'm Brian and you are watching BV3D. This episode of the BV3D channel is brought to you in part by these awesome channel members. Hi, welcome back. Hey, if you're new here and you're wanting to learn about 3D printing, 3D modeling, and other 3D printing related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Okay, so today we're going to get those V-slot wheels on your 3D printer adjusted just right. So I guess first, let's start with why this even needs to be done. A 3D printer is obviously a mechanical thing with moving parts. The heated bed is mounted to the Y carriage. The Z axis has the entire X axis mounted to it. And on the X axis, the printhead is mounted to the X carriage. And on something like the Ender 3 series, all of these parts are able to move by rolling on wheels like this. This is a V-slot wheel, and it's designed specifically to roll along in the slots in the aluminum extrusions. Interestingly, by an astonishing coincidence, these aluminum extrusions are called V-slot aluminum extrusions. Nobody knows why. Okay, that was funnier when I was writing it, not so much now. But getting back to the subject at hand, the reason the wheels need to be adjusted is that from the factory, sometimes they're either too loose or too tight. When they're set too tightly, the wheels will develop flat spots on them if they stay in one position too long. And you can feel those flat spots when you move the printhead or the bed manually. If they are set too loosely, the parts attached to them, the bed or the printhead or the entire X-axis, can wobble or be imprecise. And these issues can adversely affect your print quality. So that's why they need to be properly adjusted. You'll generally see four of these wheels on the Y carriages of printers with smaller beds and six of them on larger ones. On the X and Z axis parts, these wheels are usually arranged in a triangular formation. Two wheels on one side of the aluminum extrusion and one wheel on the other side. And the distance between the wheels and the slots they ride in can be adjusted by means of the eccentric nut, which certain of these wheels are mounted to. Eccentric just means the center hole is a little bit off-center. So when you rotate that nut, the center hole moves. It looks like this. The result is that rotating the nut moves the wheel closer to, then further away from, the extrusion. I have a couple of pieces of an Ender 3 Pro here, so we'll be able to get good shots of the process. Now let's start with the Y carriage. This is the part that carries the heated bed, and on the Ender 3 Pro, this rides on a 40-40 V-slot aluminum extrusion. The Y carriage has two wheels on one side with eccentric nuts, and two wheels on the other side without. I'm going to start with the wheels way too loose. See how wobbly the carriage is? That's going to result in absolutely terrible print quality with the bed shaking around all over the place. So using a 10 millimeter wrench, this is just a slightly fancier version of the little one that probably came with your printer, I'm going to rotate that eccentric nut. And you can see that it's bringing the wheel closer to the extrusion. I'm making small adjustments and checking whether the wheel can still spin freely. If the wheel can spin easily, then I keep turning the eccentric nut until it can't. I mean, I still want to be able to move it, even when it's touching the extrusion. I just want it to take a little bit of force to overcome that friction. Now that I have this one set, I'm going to check the other one. Now, of course, the other one is also super loose because I deliberately made them loose to show you what that looked like. But I'm following the same process. Make small adjustments and check whether the wheel moves easily or needs a little bit of force. Lather, rinse, repeat. Okay, that takes care of the wheels on the bed. See? Much better. The Y carriage moves easily, but it doesn't wobble. That's what we want. Now it's time to adjust the wheels on the X carriage. And just like with the Y carriage, a wobbly X carriage will contribute to poor print quality because the printhead would be wiggling around, never able to be accurately positioned. So this is the same process as for the bed's wheels, but there's only one wheel that needs to be adjusted. And that's the wheel on this side of the extrusion that's just sitting there, sad, and all alone. You know, it's trying to hang out with its friends, but those two are really into each other, and this one here just kind of feels like a third wheel. But despite that, it has a job to do, and we're going to help it do the best job it possibly can. Okay, little V-slot roller wheel, it's time to straighten up and roll right. And also roll left. So again, check the fit, make small adjustments, check the fit, small adjustments, check the fit, lather, rinse, repeat, until there's some friction but you can still turn the wheel without moving the X carriage and there's no more wobble. Now that you've got the hang of it, the wheels on the Z axis are arranged in a triangle exactly like on the X carriage, so you can perform the same operation there. And that's it. I hope you had a wheel good time today. Now check these every once in a while, maybe once a month, or if you happen to notice that the bed or the printhead have a little bit of wobble. Adjust them if they need it, and have fun printing things. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this episode. And now that things are running smoothly, let's go print something cool. Hey, real quick before you go, I wanted to say thanks for being one of the super awesome people who sticks around all the way to the end, and thanks for all the likes, comments, and shares. And an especially big thanks to those who directly support what I do. You're all wonderful for doing that, and I really appreciate it. If you liked this episode, a thumbs up would be great, and if you'd like to help support the channel, check the description for ways you can do exactly that. And hey, if you haven't already subscribed, please do. It's absolutely free, and it's an excellent way to help keep me making these videos for you. Well, that's it for this one. Thanks again, and I'll see you next time here on the BV3D channel.